So a big part of stopping the spread of COVID-19 has been limiting our travel, with today marking 200 days since the Canada-U.S. border closed. But with no end in sight to the pandemic, health experts are looking at ways we might be able to reopen our borders safely. Joining us this morning is Vivek Goel, a professor at Dalhousie School of Public Health. Good to have you with us.
Good morning.
How much of a difference are border closures making in our COVID-19 case numbers?
A tremendous difference. So back in March, February, we were having most of our cases were related to travel, either the people that came into the country or the people that were exposed to them. Since the borders closed, that proportion has dropped substantially. And certainly right now, it is something we need to continue to do because we need to manage the cases at home.
What markers do we need to hit before we can consider easing some of these border restrictions?
So first of all, we have to get things under control at home. As you know, we're in the middle of our second wave. We have to get that under control. And then we have to make sure we're ready for future peaks and valleys or waves and make sure we have adequate testing and contact tracing capacity. And then we also have to look at what's happening everywhere else in the world and make sure the countries that we're going to expect travelers from have things under control.
You've taken a look at the data of international travelers that come into Toronto right now because there is some travel happening for essential workers. From what you're seeing, is it possible to safely reopen the border if the virus is still around without a vaccine?
Yeah, I think it's going to be possible. Right now, we're doing a study to demonstrate what those rates actually are and the feasibility of testing people on arrival at the airport, having them do tests at home and follow up. I would hope that by the time our study is done and things are brought under control, the data will help inform future government policy that might allow for shorter quarantine periods and a program of testing on arrival and testing a few days afterwards.
The question is when, Professor Goel, that's what everybody wants to know. And based on the models that you're looking at, when can you give us a rough ballpark? Is it months? Is it weeks? Is it a year?
I think anyone who's started to predict things during this pandemic has more often been wrong than right. But I would certainly say, given where things are at right now in Canada and the United States and the rest of the world, it's unlikely that we're going to see complete relaxation of the border restrictions anytime soon, certainly not in the next few weeks or the next few months.
So even with the restrictions in place, people are breaking them. We've seen reports of Americans being fined for abusing what's called the Alaska loophole. How can countries enforce restrictions, or really does it just come down to a matter of trust?
Well, I think this is where our study may also be helpful. So even if you are maintaining the quarantine, we know it's not always going to be perfect, right? So perhaps a strategy of testing may actually turn out to be safer than a strategy of a strict 14-day quarantine, which in a democratic society is very difficult to implement. Unless we're going to build quarantine hotels and facilities and try to keep everyone locked up, it's hard to ensure that all the people that are in quarantine actually respect it. The other thing that we could start to consider is, can we have people that are coming into the country accept to have some form of location-based monitoring with their cell phones, checking in every day, confirming their location using their GPS. We know there are concerns around privacy and civil liberties with things like that, but people that are choosing to travel may be prepared to give up on some of those privacy rights in order to have the ability to travel.
Yeah, you bring up a really good point. There are a lot of countries in the world right now that if you travel to them, and they want you to be there, they need you to support tourism industry, but they do have what you call quarantine hotels, where from the airport they are taken to a hotel where they have to stay for 10 days to 2 weeks, and then they're allowed to move about freely. Is that something you could see us doing here in order to, with the end goal being opening the border?
So I don't know that that would serve the end goal of opening up the border. I think countries that are doing that sort of activity, for example, Caribbean islands, are saying you can come, they're certifying resorts to manage this, and then you can come and stay at the resort for your 2 weeks. That's your holiday and you go back home. To come in and spend 2 weeks in a hotel and then start your holiday, I think is probably going to be more challenging in terms of restoring tourism. But there are places in the country, on the coast and so on, that are resort-like settings, and perhaps that sort of approach could be tried in settings like that.
There's always the mountains in Banff as well. Professor exactly. Goel, good to have you with us this morning. Okay. Thank you.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.